Hello, this is Tom and Chris with Those Film Guys, and for our second part of our Bat Marathon, we will be reviewing and giving an in-depth look into Tim Burton's 1989 Batman film. And to begin with, our general thoughts on Tim Burton's Batman. And I'll start with you, Chris. What were your opening thoughts?
Well, this was the first superhero film I ever saw as a kid. I've got it on video. It was a 15, and I kept pestering my mum to let me watch it when I was like 6 years old. Eventually, she caved in, and I love this film, and still to this day, it's probably my favourite Batman film of all time.
Okay.
Because I don't know whether it's because I watched it at a young age, it's had that lasting impact on me, but even today, I think it still holds up as the best look and feel for Batman.
Okay.
Well, how about you?
I am on the other side. I did not like it at all. Not one. Well, I mean, there is stuff to like about it, but overall, yeah, it's very boring and very long as well, even though it's only, 2 hours?
It's just over 2 hours, yeah.
And it feels like nothing really gets accomplished in it. We see Batman, then we see the Joker, and we'll get into those two a bit more often, and then it just sort of, they fight, and then it ends, and Joker gets defeated, and then it ends, and that's what it felt like. I was watching, it felt too routine for me, like far too routine.
It follows the typical conventions of good guy versus bad guy, they fight it out, end of film. It follows that, and it does, watching it again, it does kind of get a bit slow towards the middle mark.
Yeah.
But overall, it's still probably my favourite Batman film.
I think the problem I have with it is that it's, well, actually, because I've got multiple problems in the categories we've sort of got, I'll go through them and we'll, your general feeling was you liked it, it's your favourite Batman film.
Highest praise from me, yeah.
Not so high praise from me, but I didn't particularly care for it as much as, say, I know it's a cult film and everything, but I, you know, I've got to be honest, I don't really see why. But, you know, going to a section we have with the change in direction that it was going, it made it feel darker.
Yeah, it was around about this time that the comics of Batman were moving away from the more 60s feel of being very campy and over the top.
Yeah.
And started to focus on more issues of the time period that it was set in, and Batman took on a more darker, you know, tone. And this was brought forth in the film directed by Tim Burton.
Yeah, I think he did. I don't think he changed particularly. I mean, he changed the look. I mean, the look is drastically different from previous, like the Adam West Batman, like vastly different. Where that was cartoonish and colourful, this is more black and dark and greys. It's got loads of. It's got all the saturation sort of. It feels depressing. It feels like a depressing place to live, and that's probably what he was going for, and it you know, praise to the art department and art direction for coming up with that sort of vision or converting Tim Burton's sort of ideas into that.
Tim Burton is a very good visual director, and I think that's. Sometimes some people say he has more style over substance, but, and you could argue that, but here you can't fault the look of Gotham City and, you know, the costumes and everything. It looks gritty, it looks dirty, it looks, as you said, depressing.
I think as well, to me, what you said just there was about Tim Burton, you can argue that he looks for style over substance. But I think to me, is sort of the epitome of that. It feels very stylized, yet it doesn't feel like it has much weight behind it. I mean, you look at previous superhero films, before we started recording, you mentioned Superman. But Superman actually had some sort of... It had character arcs, and it had characters you could relate to and you could feel for, and it had an overall arc for the character of Superman, Clark Kent. Here, I don't feel the same with any of the characters. I just feel that they're there to bring on another set piece. It doesn't feel like they're entirely real and have much motivation in the way of characters and in the way of their story arcs. It just feels like they're there to serve the story, or they're there to move on to the next set piece. And that's really what, and that's even true for Batman. That's how I feel about Batman as well in this. And you know, I can't really get over that idea that it's more stylized than anything, yet there's no sort of emotional weight behind it.
Yeah, I can see what you mean, and I'm inclined to agree, but I think it's more through the dialogue and the mannerisms of the characters that make them so likable, not so much in their like emotional struggles and, you know, through that way.
Okay.
But really, Tim Burton, his directorial credentials before this, he only really had Pee-wee the Movie, which I've never seen, and Beetlejuice, and, you know, Michael Keaton coming straight off Beetlejuice into the role of Batman, I know at the time caused a lot of controversy, because everyone was like, how can this comedic actor play such a serious role as Bruce Wayne and Batman?
Yeah.
So I personally see this as Tim Burton's real big break as a director. Although I love Beetlejuice, but I see this as his, you know, proper opus into, you know, directing.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing that I'd like to move on to, which is the Batman and the actual Batman, Bruce Wayne. Going back to Keaton, which you said he's comedic actor, come into this sort of role that's much darker, much sort of it's not the role that he played previously, and I don't particularly think he did well. I mean, he was good in it, but I don't think he really pushed it to levels that maybe I was expecting. Pushed his performance to sort of, because I mean, the thing is with Keaton and the Bruce Wayne Batman sort of story arc, there is not an origin story. That is the one thing we have to clear up. It is not an origin story. So anyone expecting it to be an origins story about Batman, you're going to be sorely disappointed. I mean, because there are hints to backstory in there and hints to origins, but
they come more towards the end of the film.
Yeah. And there's a scene I want to mention now, which is which goes back to Keaton's performance. It's where he's puts two roses on this sort of ground.
Oh yeah.
And that, of course, is where his parents were killed. But I think that it doesn't feel like he's really... I know it's supposed to be a more subtle performance. He's sort of internally dealing with it. But I would also, I would also like to see some sort of external battle with it, with the death of his parents. Like, he places the roses down, walks off, and it doesn't seem like he's at all sad or about it. I know that's that it's in the subtleties of his performance, but I'd like to see a little bit of external, of him playing it externally.
I like the fact that he stores all his emotion and he keeps it all to himself, because you can see from the look after he puts the roses down, they hold this shut for a few seconds of his face, and you can see that he is, you know, tortured by this memory, and then he walks off. And that's what I quite like, because it's only through the Vicky Vale character that he feels that he can open up to someone, that he's stored this, you know, ordeal for all his life.
Mm.
And I quite like that aspect of the character.
Yeah. As well, Bruce Wayne. The thing is, I don't think Keaton plays a good Bruce Wayne.
No, neither do I.
He's supposed to be the sort of billionaire playboy, genius philanthropist, you know, Iron Man sort of thing. But it seemed to me like it was a hard balancing act to try and get those two personalities to be completely different. Because I saw it as Keaton playing pretty much the same character as Batman with Bruce Wayne. I didn't feel any difference between the two. Because, I mean, Bruce Wayne and Batman are supposed to be juxtaposing. One's supposed to look a certain way, and one's supposed to sort of act a certain way to sort of make everybody sort of think he's something he's not. And the other, and Batman being his sort of true sort of fight for justice sort of character, I felt that he was playing the same sort of character with Batman as Bruce Wayne, and I didn't think he really did enough to convince me, at least, that he was playing Bruce Wayne any differently.
Now, Michael Keaton's portrayal of Batman is my favourite Batman of all time. I just think the voice, the look, the mannerisms as is Batman are just the quintessential Batman archetype that even in the modern versions I really miss. I think Keaton played Batman so well, but I see what you mean about his portrayal of Bruce Wayne. It doesn't have any standout qualities. There's no difference in how he acts. Yeah. He doesn't act, you know, like he's trying to like get over his parents' death and put on this facade to the crowd. It seems like he is still tortured by this, and he just comes across as like a kind of weird, you know, rich guy.
Yeah.
But as Batman, I think he's the best ever put on screen.
I'm still not sure what to make of Keaton's Batman, and I know that's sort of a thing everyone thinks that, or most everyone thinks that he's the best, but I'm still not, you know, he is very good as Batman. Like you said, the mannerisms of his acting and the way he moves is good. But I'm still not entirely convinced about, you know, that it is a different character I'm seeing. I'm still not convinced that his performance is particularly the best.